Hey now, good morning PASW staff, clients, and friends joining us for a lovely Monday. Hope you guys had a great weekend, restful weekend. Really good job with Mission Impossible last week. We found really good spy music, that genre, Lalo Schifrin's famous Mission Impossible theme score, and that was just really fun to see the results. You guys did great work. If you're joining us for the first time, or, you know, need a refresher, Film Scoring Monday is when we look at a scene that I've chosen, a certain special scene, and I take out the music, and you think of what best could replace the score. And this is when we're music supervisors, or music composers, sort of, because it is pre-existing music. If you want to write your own music, of course, that's extra credit, so that would be great too. So, and then you send me the score, and then we see it on Friday. So that's how this has been working for over about a year and a half at least. So play along, and you know, I help you guys out if you need anything, but you guys are pretty solid with sending me stuff and it looking really great. So very proud of you guys. Good work. We're going to continue to do good work. We have another, so this isn't a spy movie. This is kind of a mystery, surreal mystery, neo-noir. I'll get to those terms later, just in case there's any confusion. We're going to look at a great director, too. So today we'll be looking at the kind of creepy-ish film from the mind of David Lynch, Mulholland Drive. Mulholland Drive, the tagline, David Lynch, the director, is a love story in the city of dreams. But it's not a romantic story at all. Just for our LA history, I'm going to incorporate a little bit. Mulholland Drive, we've all heard of that. It's a street and road kind of near the Santa Monica Mountains in Southern California, named after William Mulholland, who's a brilliant engineer. Probably without Mulholland, we would not be here living in Los Angeles, because this is kind of a desert place and there wasn't any water supply until this engineer, self-taught brilliant engineer, came along and said, well, we can steal water, not condoning stealing, but from the Owens River Valley. So we could do a whole class on that scandal, because we did actually, that's kind of the whole perhaps lie that Hollywood and LA is based on, that we have never had our own water source, so we had to steal it from somebody. But okay, so this Mulholland Drive, the movie, is from the very famous street, Danger Street, too. So it's kind of a psychological, surreal thriller. There's a lot of open ends. That's from the mind of David Lynch. David Lynch is an American filmmaker, painter, musician, writer. He's a very, very famous director, 75 years old right now, born in 1946. And this movie was written, directed by him, comes out in 2001, and stars Naomi Watts. This is one of her first roles. She was going to give up acting until this role came to her. Laura Haring, Justin Theroux, and the classic Ann Miller. People have kind of compared this to Billy Wilder's film noir, Sunset Boulevard. Just so we're clear, film noir, we've talked about it a little bit, but it's French, noir. It's a term, a cinematic term, kind of that describes a lot of those Hollywood, dark Hollywood style films in the 40s, 50s. Usually, like black and white, and very kind of a raw, gritty visual style. That goes back to German Expressionism. That's the kind of mood. It's very moody. There's usually, you know, there's sometimes a detective, a femme fatale, LA Confidential. It's a great genre of filmmaking. This is kind of like a neo, meaning new, noir, because it's a dark film. But David Lynch, made his probably biggest film as a Eraserhead, 1977, which was. I thought about doing, but so that score was a little bit kind of more far out than I wanted to go for this class. But that became a really successful midnight movie circuit. Great, weird, quirky film. And then The Elephant Man in 1980 gained a lot of popularity with that. Dune, and then Blue Velvet in 1986. Blue Velvet, brilliant, but very disturbing. So don't watch that if you don't viewed, but great. He's really great at using surrealism and metaphors in cinema, which is something American directors don't do that much. American directors are more linear storytellers. European people and people like David Lynch are a little bit open to interpretation and surrealism and those kind of things. The budget for this is $15 million. Makes $20 million. The plot is this aspiring actress, Naomi Watts, comes to Los Angeles, meets and befriends this woman who was in this car accident in the beginning, and she's suffering from amnesia. She doesn't remember what happened, and there's all these vignettes. And then there's also a Hollywood director, and that's Justin Theroux's character. And there's all these little things that are just odd. His environment that he creates is just it's very odd. So at first it was a television pilot, and he shot a lot of the movie in 1999 and wanted to keep it open-ended so he could have a series for ABC, but the executives rejected it. So he decided to use the footage, make it a feature film, shoot more footage. Who's the composer? He's worked with David Lynch on all of his movies. I mean, mostly all of his movies, going back to starting with Blue Velvet. Angelo Badalamenti, born 1937, American composer, scored Blue Velvet and Twin Peaks. That's all I forgot to mention. You know, that's a big, that's one of David Lynch's things. Received a Grammy Award for Best Pop Instrumental Performance for his Twin Peaks theme, which is a very, very famous theme. Got a bachelor's from the Eastman School of Music, one of the best music schools in the world, and then master's degree in composition and French horn from Manhattan School of Music in 1960, another great music conservatory. So he was first, Isabella Rossellini, famous actress, was in Blue Velvet, and he became known because he was her singing coach for this, and David Lynch, they hit it off, and kind of, so he just happened to come with Isabella Rossellini to this to kind of coach her vocals, and David Lynch became collaborators after that. So that's kind of how he got into David Lynch's mind, because we've talked about directors and composers working together, and usually when they find one that works, they stick with it. We talked about John Williams and Steven Spielberg, Michael Nyman, Peter Greenaway. I mean, you know, we've talked so many about that. So directors and composers, you know, collaborate together, because obviously music is so important, as we know, to the scene, you know, the movie, the mood, everything, you know. So the score to this, as we're kind of hearing, is very dark, right? Ominous. Because it's a mystery film, it's a surreal, dark mystery film. The sound design, Lynch worked with Badalamenti to do 10 to 12 minute tracks, very slow tempo, and Lynch would kind of take fragments of this and create soundscapes, eerie soundscapes. Soundscapes are kind of music to create an atmosphere. You know, so long drones, sustains, these sustaining notes, sounds that can be sometimes background noise, sound effects, and then musical instruments, in this case strings, kind of creating this kind of whole sound world. So that's kind of what soundscapes are. So there's droning synthesizers, droning meaning sustaining, and then there's with strings on top, and that's these strings in this movie recorded by the Prague Symphony Orchestra. So it's pretty cool. So the scene we're going to be looking at is a very opening scene of the movie. We see the street sign of Mulholland Drive late at night. Again, very dangerous drive, road. It's eerie. It's winding and all that stuff. Why don't we just take a look at it, and we'll talk about it. So what's the score? The it's eerie, right? The scores are, it's just four chords, four minor chords. A minor, they're descending. G minor,
F,
E minor. Then it repeats back. So there's strings. There's kind of dark synths underneath it. What world are we in? Are we in a romantic world? No. But we're seeing LA, right? I mean, just because I saw it recently, I mean, if you put in a different kind of song, it completely changes the mood. The great film Swingers, this is how Swingers opens.
You're nobody till somebody loves you. You're nobody till somebody cares. You may be king, you may possess the world and its gold, but gold won't bring you happiness when you're growing old.
It'd be funny to put that Elemente score with Swingers, because that's Dean Martin. We know it's a romantic comedy from the beginning. Before even one word is spoken of dialogue, you know what you're in. The scene we just watched from Mulholland Drive, you know what environment you're in. That's how important the movie is. Without the director saying anything, without any actors, you know it. Okay, fine. Nothing in LA. I'll put in my, this is how my movie opens. Nothing like Mulholland Drive scene, but it's still shots of LA in the beginning. The Swingers and Nothing in Los Angeles, I'm not comparing those two, but those opening scenes of LA shots, this is the same. Mulholland Drive is way different. So let's take a look at the scene without any of the music. So I don't want a romantic comedy. I just wanted to show you how, you know, important the score can be. Let's find something kind of eerie and dark for Mulholland Drive, since it is a very dark story about LA, and there's a lot of light and darkness in the City of Angels, as we know. That's why we do our LA classes. And let's see what you can come up with. Something kind of eerie and ominous and dark, and should be pretty easy. This isn't going to be any loud beats going on. This isn't going to be any spy music. This isn't, you know, heroic, really, music. Try to get gritty and see what you can come up with, because this is scary. There's a car accident that happens right after this scene, which I didn't show, but we know with the music something isn't quite right. It's unsettling, but we don't know yet. So try to find some music that's unsettling, maybe. And then get it to me by tomorrow. And it should be a great week. So we're going to have a lot of fun. And okay, that's it. I'll see you tomorrow, and have a great rest of the day. Bye.